So after my lemon drizzle cake, I was inundated with photographs of what everybody had been baking. And my friend sent me a picture of a lemon meringue cake. And everybody commented on how good it looked, and it was just amazing. So I've got the recipe off her, and I'm going to make it. So in my trusty food mixer, which is now called Doris, I've creamed together butter and sugar, and then I've added 3 egg yolks. Now to this, I'm going to add the 1 lemon, grated lemon, plain flour, a teaspoon of baking powder, the juice of half a lemon, and 5 tablespoons of milk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, I can count. And I fold that in. Mix it up. And I'm going to put these in a greased lined cake tin. So that's my cake mix done. So in trusty Doris, I've made my meringue, which I've put 3 egg whites in, and then I've slowly added caster sugar and whisked it up to make my meringue. Now the best way to know if meringue is ready, is they say, is to tip it on top of your head. So if I tip it up, it shouldn't come out. There you go. That's ready to top on top of my cakes. So in my grease lined tin, I've put my cake mix on the top, bottom, and then I've put my meringue on the top. I'm going to put them in the oven on 180 for 30 minutes, and then we'll see if they'll come out. So my cakes have been in the oven for about 30 minutes. So let's have a look what they look like. Oh, wow. Look at them. Perfect. I'm going to leave them in the tins for about 10 minutes to cool. Then I'll let them out after, and then I'll show you how we finish them off. Looking forward to these. So this is the finished lemon meringue cake. Oh, it looks amazing. It's got lemon curd inside, which I'll show you how to make as well, and double cream, and it's all ready there to serve up. So what do you think, Paul?
That is a fantastic cake. Well done, Ryle.
Thank you.